Asher Audio presents The Organised Mum Method, Transform Your Home in 30 Minutes a Day, written and read by Gemma Bray. Introduction. Hi, I'm Gemma Bray. I wasn't always organised. I wasn't the girl at school who had an enviable selection of highlighter pens or immaculately covered books, nor was I neat and tidy like I am now. I had to learn. In fact, even my own mum finds it hilarious that I'm writing a book about cleaning and organisation. But I am a very different woman from the teenager who once found a week-old packed lunch under her bed. I'm just getting that story out now so that my mum can't share her favourite anecdote from my childhood with you all once this book is published. To be fair, though, my mum did once offer to teach me to iron. My response? When I'm rich and famous, I will have an entourage do that kind of stuff for me. Oh, the naivety of youth. I still don't iron much, however, because I've found loads of ways to cut the ironing pile down to almost zero. But more on that a little later on. When I was younger, running an organised home held no value for me. That was until I had children. It was my catalyst for change. And believe me, if I can change, so can you. In my early 20s, I found myself married and pregnant. I realised quickly that kids pretty much change everything. I suddenly became overwhelmed by the number of things I should be doing in the house. I was a mum, and in my head that meant I had to have an immaculate home with banana bread baking in the oven, fresh flowers on the kitchen table, and Kath Kidston everything. I couldn't afford Kath Kidston, so that meant I was already on the back foot. As much as my mum tried to teach me to iron, I really didn't know the basics of what I needed to be doing with the housework and how often I needed to be doing it. How often did I need to clean the loo? How regularly do the bed sheets need changing? And what are all these strange accessories that come with a vacuum cleaner? It really overwhelmed me, and I started to drive myself into the ground with the amount of stuff I was trying to achieve in an attempt to keep up with the perfect mum ideal that I had created in my mind. I distinctly remember the health visitor coming to the house when my eldest was just days old and I was still healing from the birth. I thought that if my bathroom wasn't super clean, she would think that I was a bad mum. I got down on my hands and knees and scrubbed the floor until you could eat your dinner off it. Not something you want to do when you're recovering from a forceps delivery. Nevertheless, I did it because I thought that was what was expected of me. And the irony of this story is that she never even asked to use the bathroom. It soon became clear that I needed to approach life differently. I was overcleaning and exhausted. I felt as though I was on a treadmill of never-ending chores, and I never really had time to do anything fun. I hardly saw my friends, and my life was a cycle of cleaning, baby care, and sleeping. I was also a bit of a rubbish cook. I grew up in the 1980s when turkey drummers and Pop-Tarts were king. My mum and dad owned a fish and chip shop in Manchester and used to work 12-hour days, 6 days a week. They didn't have the time or the energy to start cooking again when we got home, so it was quick, easy food. When I had my first baby, I was running a fish and chip shop of my very own, and my diet was still something with chips and beans most nights. I quickly realised that in a few months I'd be cooking for a newly weaning baby, and oven chips were not going to make the grade. This meant that cooking was something else that I needed to add to the list of things I had to learn. I didn't want to eat beige food anymore, nor did I want my life to revolve around housework. Before I became a mum, I was sold this amazing vision of motherhood. But of course, life isn't the way it's depicted in magazines, on Instagram, or in the ads you see on TV, of mums dressed in white skinny jeans feeding their baby carrot puree, never a practical combination. I needed a cunning plan. Not one to be beaten, I sat down at my kitchen table, where there were still no fresh flowers, and wrote a housekeeping plan on a piece of notepaper. Then I stuck it on the fridge. The organised mum method was born. Or, as everyone who follows the plan calls it, TOMM. It was easy to follow, it worked, and it got everything done in 30 minutes a day from Monday to Friday. I didn't want to spend my weekends cleaning and doing the laundry. Little did I realise that this plan would become a way of life for me, and that over a decade later, it would have evolved into a blog that would revolutionise the way other people view housework. I also taught myself how to cook. After a little practice, I realised that I actually enjoyed cooking. But now that I had a new baby on my hip, I didn't have the time to spend hours chopping and stirring. I began to teach myself simple recipes that were easy to make and tasted delicious. and I added to them and perfected them as the years went by. I have included some of these recipes in this book. They are perfect for people who don't have much time but who love good food. They won't have you chained to the hob in the early evening, which, as any parent knows, is the time of day that is already fraught without throwing cooking into the mix. That was 12 years ago. Fast forward to today and I have three children, all boys, a dog, also a boy, and a husband, a man. I have followed Tom the whole time, no matter what was going on in my life. It has seen me through a divorce and becoming a single mum to two young children, running a business, two fish and chip shops, I make the best mushy peas, teaching antenatal classes and being on 24-hour call as a doula. Tom has remained consistent throughout those various stages of my life. Not only was it essential when I was a single mum, but now that I am happily married to Mike, it provides us with a way of managing the housework equally while we both work full time. I promise you that Tom works. Not only that, it is life changing. If you want the same things as I did 12 years ago, let me hold your hand, stroke your hair, and guide you through the chaos to a calmer and happier home. We'll have some laughs along the way, and hopefully you'll see that housework doesn't need to be overwhelming or time consuming. I will show you how to fit the housework into your busy life, whether you live alone, work shifts, have a large family, or have just moved out of home for the first time. Together, we'll tackle some of the most common cleaning conundrums, such as how to minimise or avoid the ironing, and how to make sure your odd socks don't breed. This book isn't just for mums. We all know that being female doesn't mean that you are the default housekeeper. This book is for families, couples, shift workers, grandparents, and everyone in between. You might even like to buy a copy for your grown-up kids who are just about to start university, in the hope that they won't have to bring home bags of laundry every time they visit. I aim to make the housework as easy and as painless as possible. But I'm a realistic woman. That is the northerner in me. I know that there will be times when you might not feel like cleaning, cooking, or doing anything other than sitting on the sofa and eating your way through a whole tube of Pringles. But these are the times when I will have you covered. I have paved the way and found the shortcuts, and in this book, I will pass them on to you. Are you ready to start your journey? Let's go. Part 1. Getting Started. Chapter 1. The Organised Mum Method. Tom. And why it works. There's more to life than housework. This little saying is so true, but I suspect you weren't expecting to read it in a book that is dedicated to it. I strongly believe that we need to learn to balance the need for housework with actually living. We can't abandon the dusting completely, but neither should we let it rule us. When I first shared Tom with the great British public, I never in my wildest dreams thought that it would become the phenomenon that it has. I followed Tom privately for years before I shared it, and for that reason I hold it very close to my heart. It gave me a way of keeping everything together as a mum, enabled me to work and to spend time with my friends and family, all without sacrificing my sanity and without the house falling apart at the seams. It was only 2 years ago, on New Year's Eve, that I decided to go public with Tom. And it was all down to Tom, my firstborn, although it's a total coincidence with the name. He dared me to share my way of cleaning with the world. At first, I was nervous. At the time, Instagram was full of beautiful celebs showing off their arty avocado on toast shots. But it seems that people needed Tom in their life as much as I did. The first year was a whirlwind. I went from being a mum of three children, still on maternity leave with my youngest, to a blogger, YouTuber, and Instagrammer. For someone who is not very tech savvy, it was a very steep learning curve. But one of the most heartwarming things for me is that even though the rise of Tom's popularity was fast, so many of you who followed me at the very start are still following along today. In fact, I scrolled all the way back to my first Instagram post a few days ago, and one of the people who liked it is now one of the moderators for our Facebook group. How amazing is that? We have built up an incredible Team Tom community, and now you're part of that too. It is so lovely to have you with us. Here we are, 2 years later, and the nation has taken Tom to its heart. It has even flown as far afield as the United States, Australia, and New Zealand. This always makes me smile because something that I thought up one day at my kitchen table has started to transform the lives of so many. Every day, I get messages from people who have turned to Tom and found that it has revolutionised the way they look at housework. It is helping people's mental health and giving them much more time to focus on their families, careers and hobbies. What's not to love? I've even been stopped in the cleaning aisle of the supermarket and been asked my opinion on which is the best product to remove limescale from a shower door. I love this so much. So if you ever see me out and about, give me a wave. I still live and breathe the method, and that's simply because it works. It enables me to do my job, have time where I can sit down and play with my kids, and it gives me housework-free weekends. Why TOMM works. TOMM is a simple, efficient housekeeping plan that makes it easy to keep on top of everything in your home and leaves you free to do all the other things you'd rather be doing. My motto, get in, get it done, and then get out of there. The method requires just 30 minutes of cleaning each day, Monday to Friday. Weekends are purposely kept housework free so you can enjoy your time off without having to do a mammoth clean. Each day, from Monday to Thursday, has its own focus room. Living room on Monday, bedrooms on Tuesday, and so on. And these never change. Every Friday, a room gets an additional deep clean, called the Friday Focus, rotating on an 8-week cycle. TOMM is really easy to follow once you get started, but that can often be the hardest part. Before I go into more detail about the method, let's consider what makes TOMM so special and how TOMM can work for you and your individual circumstances. Go straight to chapter 3 if you're already familiar with the method and you are just looking for a refresher. The super efficient 30 minutes. I know just how easy it can be to let housework creep into every part of your day. You start dusting, and then a few minutes later, bored, you pick up your phone, have a little bit of a scroll through Facebook or Instagram, and before you know it, 20 minutes have passed and you're still holding your duster, but no dusting has actually taken place. Sound familiar? This is why it seems that housework takes forever. If you are not focusing on the task at hand and are allowing yourself to become distracted, it will, obviously, take longer. And let's get real, sometimes anything can seem more appealing than a job that you don't want to do. How many times have you become faux busy in order to avoid a task that you've been putting off? We allow ourselves to get distracted, but all we are doing is putting off the inevitable. It's far better to get your head down, focus, get it done, and then get out of there. This is why TOMM works in 30-minute chunks, to give you a solid 30 minutes of distraction-free time. If you have never done anything like this before, I promise you that you will be shocked at how much you can achieve. What's more, 30 minutes isn't that long, so it can be shoehorned into your day. I usually do mine first thing in the morning. I like to leave the house knowing that when I get in after a long day, I won't have to lift a finger. If you're a bit sceptical and fancy a bit of a challenge, try this. Stop listening, set your timer for 30 minutes and use that time to tackle a job that you have been putting off. I guarantee that once the 30 minutes is up, you'll feel fab about the fact that you've ticked a job off your list. You might even be motivated to tackle something else. The amount of cleaning you get done in 30 minutes is always quite staggering too. You'll be shocked at how much is achievable. Again, if you're thinking, this woman is crazy, set your timer for 15 minutes and see how much you can smash through. And that is just in 15 minutes. Imagine what you can achieve in 30. I get so many messages from people saying that they are bowled over by how much they get done in the time. It isn't just me who's operating on some kind of turbocharged cleaning speed. The 30 minutes, however, is only half of the story. The Friday Focus. The real key to TOMM, and the reason why your home will get cleaner and cleaner every week you follow the method, is the Friday Focus. Let me explain how it works. Your TOMM week is structured so that every Monday to Thursday, you will have the same jobs to do, and these never change. After a few weeks, you will know them off by heart, and you will be into your stride. You won't even have to check what you are supposed to be doing. But every Friday, we change it up, and an area of your home will get a deeper level of focus, a mini spring clean, if you like. By the way, if you follow TOMM, you won't have to spring clean again because your home will always have a good rotational cleaning system going on. That's another added bonus of the method. The Friday focus operates over an 8-week cycle. So every Friday, you'll be in a new area of the home, going one level deeper than you usually clean during Monday to Thursday. I told you it was simple. TOMM will give you structure. You won't suddenly find yourself with a few spare minutes and panic about how you can use them to your best advantage. You now have a list and a system, and you will tick everything off as you go along. Don't aim for perfection. A little word on realism and cleaning your home while bearing in mind that people have to live there. TOMM is a realistic method for the real world. Pinterest perfect homes rarely exist. And believe me when I say that trying to achieve one will break you. I know, because I tried. When I decided to talk about TOMM online, I started by dipping my toe into the water of Instagram. It felt like I was whispering about my method into a massive room filled with people who were posting pictures of gorgeous kitchens and living rooms, homes that looked like they would have been perfectly suited to an episode of Grand Designs. This made me feel uncomfortable for two reasons. One, I don't think that showing people an unobtainable lifestyle is motivational. It is totally unrealistic for many of us to live some of the lifestyles that we are shown on social media. And the aspirations that are born from scrolling can be damaging to our mental health. Two, I know for a fact that in some of the pictures you see of perfectly straightened coffee tables, there is a whole heap of mess shoved just out of shot. Just as people might Photoshop their bodies when they post that bikini picture, be wary of the perfect home pictures too. Our homes need to function. Our home houses our family. That means lots of bodies breathing, eating, sleeping, and just generally getting on with life. If you try to maintain a perfect show home, you will always be straightening the coffee table and forever cleaning up. Is this what you really want to be doing with your life? This is how I look at it. I'm never going to look like Cindy Crawford, circa that Pepsi advert. No matter how hard I try, my hair will never do that. And I won't be able to wear a cream bodysuit with denim hot pants because of kids, Pringles, and wine. Similarly, my house is never going to look like one of those gorgeous beach houses in the Hamptons, all white linen, white roses, and perfectly minimalist because of kids, Pringles, and wine. Let go of perfect, trust in TOMM, and give yourself permission to stop after the 30 minutes are up. If you follow TOMM, you will be doing enough cleaning, and your mental health will thank you for it. Gem's top tip. There's a difference between a dirty home and a home that is just a little bit messy because people live there. Please take a moment to think about that. It's actually highly freeing. It's perfectly possible to have a wonderfully clean home and also have a living room that's got toys all over the floor because your kids have been playing. Which type of cleaner are you? By now, I will hopefully have convinced you that TOMM is the way forward, and you'll be ready to join thousands of others all over the world who are part of Team TOMM. But first, we need to look at how you're already cleaning. You are listening because you want to change how you run your home. And I can't help you change until you understand what your stumbling block is and how TOMM can help you. Once you have worked out where you are going wrong, you'll be able to get yourself back on track and start cleaning smarter, not harder. So let's get down to it. Which type of cleaner are you? The weekender. If you're one of those people who spends their whole Saturday desperately catching up on the housework that you've missed during the week, this book is for you. If you want to reclaim your weekends and spread the housework over the week without actually realising you are doing it, stick around because it will blow your mind when you are faced with a Saturday and Sunday that are yours to do whatever you want with. There is nothing more demoralising than spending hours upon hours cleaning only for it to be undone in 30 minutes. And this is what happens if you are currently doing a mammoth clean once a week. Your home will look great when you eventually collapse with a cup of tea or wine and exhaustedly survey all your hard work. But hark, what is that we hear yonder? That, my friends, is the sound of your toddler thundering into the room to undo all your graft. When you clean the TOMM way, you not only get your weekends back, but you also spread the cleaning over the week so that the house is always in a fit state for visitors and the dirt never gets out of hand. You won't be running around in a panic trying to speed clean the house when the mother-in-law springs a surprise visit on you. For those of you who are currently stuck in this mode, please don't worry, because I have a strategy coming up in Chapter 11 for when situations like this occur, because they will occur. It is just part of life. The ostrich. If you have buried your head in the sand for a bit too long and your home resembles Primark in the sales, don't worry. Give me a week and I can help you tame the mess. First step, do not panic. Your home didn't get this way overnight, so it is unrealistic to think you can get it back to its best in a weekend. Don't fall into the trap of jumping up and shouting, right, that's it, I'm going to declutter every single cupboard, cull the garage, the shed, the loft, and we're going to get organised today. The easy part is pulling everything out of the cupboards, but then you get that sinking feeling when it dawns on you that the hard bit is next, because now you have to clean and organise and do the runs to the charity shop and list things on eBay, which all takes time and energy, which might be in short supply given everything else that you need to be doing. By this point, the tiredness sets in and you might even be tempted to move out or just shut the door. You're back to head in the sand mode. We're not going to do that. We are going to tackle one space at a time. And you are going to use the Messy House Bootcamp to finally get control once and for all. After you have completed the bootcamp, you'll be ready to start TOMM proper and join the 30 minutes a day crew. A little word about the bootcamp. Halfway through the bootcamp, you might hate me a little tiny bit, but I promise that once you are done, you will love me again. I just have to give you a bit of tough love to push you towards your goals. The firefighter. If you belong to the firefighter camp, you might be reading this in such a heightened state of frazzled exhaustion that it's possible that not everything I say will be going in. If you feel that you're constantly picking up after the kids, your partner, the dog, you're probably just chasing your tail and not actually achieving anything. People most likely to be in this camp are new parents, the parents of a toddler, and working parents. So that's basically all parents then. I'm going to need you to focus. Sit down, make yourself a cup of tea, and read the following statement over and over until it has sunk in. I am getting nowhere cleaning like this. It feels as if I am taking two steps forward and one step backward. I am achieving nothing. I need to change my strategy before I burn out. This is where TOMM will help you. There is no doubt about it. The firefighters among us need structure in order to regain control over the housework. And my method gives you that structure. When you come down in the morning, you will know what you are meant to be doing. And pretty soon you will be a well-oiled cleaning machine and your home will be an oasis of calm. I totally get it. I have three kids, so I know the chaos that can be caused in one room while you are toiling away in another. You have just spent an hour cleaning the lounge and to your horror, realise that in that time the rest of the house has been trashed while your kids have been left unattended. The good news is that not only am I going to help you get the kids and everyone else you live with on board, but I'm also going to help you put the correct strategies in place to ensure that you won't be chasing your tail or drowning in laundry. The perfectionist. TOMM isn't just for people who have lost control of the housework. It has also helped thousands who feel as though the housework has taken control of them. This was, of course, me back when I was cleaning the bathroom floor just before the health visitor popped round. My cleaning was taking over my days and it was making me miserable. Obsessive cleaning can take over people's lives, and I have spoken to many TOMMers who have successfully used the method to help take back control. Putting a time limit on the housework puts a full stop on the cleaning day and eliminates the guilt creeping in that you haven't done enough. What's more, having a clear structure means that everything gets covered and you won't waste time repeating the same jobs unnecessarily. I don't want you to waste your life cleaning for hours on end just to get demoralised when the kids storm in after footy and leave their sweaty kit all over the bedroom floor. TOMM is going to help you address the balance and get your life back. Let's get started. Chapter 2. Where do you start? Are we all assembled and raring to go? It would be madness if I expected you all to be able to start at the same point. Some of you will be joining Team TOMM from a standing start and will be able to crack on with the 30 minutes a day right away. But others might have to play a little bit of catch up. Perhaps you've had a cleaner up until now, but you have just started maternity leave and this means that your budget is stretched and a cleaner is now a luxury that you can no longer afford. If this, or something similar, is your current situation, your home will no doubt be looking pretty decent and you just need a system to help keep it that way. Or perhaps you've just moved into your very first home and you are looking for a way to keep it looking and smelling brand new. On the other hand, there will be those of you who will need a little leg up to get to the point where you're able to maintain your home in just 30 minutes a day. Perhaps you have just had a baby and up until now your home was easily tamed. But since your little bundle of joy arrived, things have become a little more challenging. That's fine. Everyone has different starting points. Wherever you are in your housekeeping journey, I don't want you to worry. We'll all be at the same place soon. It will just take some of you a little longer to get there. Think of it as taking the scenic route and me as your effervescent tour guide, making it as fun as possible along the way. What stage are you at right now? We have reached the point where some of you will stick around with me here, whereas others will be able to move on forward a little bit quicker. If you feel as though your house has been neglected for whatever reason recently, perhaps you've been ill, work has taken over, or, well, kids, then you need to stick with this section. But if you feel as though your home has been kept clean and tidy, but you are looking for a little structure to your housework and or you need help in reining in excessive cleaning, then move straight on to the section called Let's Get This Party Started. Of course, you are free to come back to this section at any time. Just look upon it as your housekeeping reset button. I want you to think of this book as your whip, and with it you're going to whip your home back into shape. Show no mercy. You can't clean clutter. Have you seen that episode of Friends where Rachel tries to clean up for Monica, but all that happens is she just dusts under piles of paperwork and magazines? Oh, how the audience laughs. The joke was on Rachel, because in order for her to truly clean up, she needed to tidy all the mess away first. But she didn't, so the room didn't look any different. Don't be Rachel. And while we're on the subject, don't be Monica. We're aiming for somewhere in between. Sometimes you can't see the wood for the trees or the dining table for the piles of washing. If you're going to embark on TOMM, you need to give yourself a head start. There is no point in setting aside 30 minutes to clean if all you do is move piles of clutter from one side of the room to the other. Let's do a very quick home audit so that you can base your next move on what you see in front of you. Take a look around your home and ask yourself the following. 1. Do you see piles of clutter and a messy house? Or 2. Do you see a fairly clutter-free home that needs a good spruce up? If you answered 1, you need to tackle the clutter buster first and then move on to the messy house bootcamp. If you answered 2, you can go straight to attacking a messy house and the messy house bootcamp. Tackling the clutter. How many out-of-date Next catalogues do you have? Do you have a room in your home that is just a storage room? Are you storing stuff that you no longer use? Do you crave more storage and are you running out of space? If this sounds familiar and you're nodding your head, don't even think about cleaning anything until you have sifted through the mountains of champagne corks from first dates, shelves from summer holidays, and clothes that no longer fit. You definitely need to embrace the clutter buster. I know that you are starting on the back foot here, and it seems like you've been kept behind a year at school. But if you jumped in with your 30 minutes a day now, you'd become despondent fast.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.